scientific tools that help us predict the weather.
And sometimes, if we listen to Mother Nature, she can give us some clues as well. And today, it's a day that we look forward to every single year. It's the Woolly Worm Forecast.
That's right. Judy's back with her own little woolly worm.
That's
here.
That's right. My little woolly weather bee. That's what I call him.
Yes. Who had a little rough go, but we've done some maintenance.
I dropped him on my way in. And he lost one of his eyes, but now we fixed it, so
he's good
to go. Although I think I need to get a new one next year.
The Cyclops woolly worm isn't quite as cute as the normal one, right?
Well, let's talk about this woolly worm, because it is a diagram, basically, of the actual woolly worms out there.
Right. The woolly worm has 13 segments, which indicate 13 weeks of winter. And so if you look at each section of the, or segment of the woolly worm, you can tell what the first 3 weeks of winter are going to be like, the in between and the end of it. So it's just kind of a way of, as you said, you know, with modern technology, the people, our early settlers, didn't have that. So they had to observe nature, whether it was insects, birds, and of course the most familiar of them all. He's the most recognizable and famous caterpillar is the woolly worm. And I've been doing this for so long, and it's just great fun to see our little backyard predictors.
I don't think I realized how much science was actually involved with it. It's obviously fun. You get good responses from people every single year.
Unbelievable. I'm always amazed at the loyalty of people in Central Illinois who always come through for me when I request the woolly worm reports. And hundreds of people, I think we had 52 communities represented.
Wow.
And
wow.
Hundreds of reports. And this year, my weather worm wranglers, I call them, have become photographers. I mean, I can't believe the beautiful pictures I've seen. It's almost like a photo studio. We have all these little woolly worms placed just so. I just love it.
Thankfully, we got the iPhones now, so when you see them, you just snap them right away.
You can
snap them, harder.
So.
And it seemed like this year there were more than last year. I remember last year kind of being hard to find them, but this year I've seen them everywhere.
There were hundreds and hundreds of woolly worms this year, but it was really this has been a tough year to forecast, because when I first put out the call, the woolly worms were of a predominant color. But then towards the end, when I started actually doing my research, they changed colors. And so it just was kind of an interesting year, very variable, like 2018 was. We had more snow in April than we did in January.
Yeah.
So this strangeness, I think, has confused the worm a little bit.
So forgive my ignorance. Are woolly worms worms? Are they caterpillars?
They're
caterpillars. Turn into something?
They turn into an Isabella tiger moth. They're really quite pretty in the spring. Their wings span, and their wings are orange and orangey yellow, and then they have little black dots on them. That's the tiger Isabella moth. So they're not butterflies, they're moths.
Yeah, we spotted some like early on.
Yes.
Remember that?
Yes,
I remember seeing it on Facebook, like, what does that mean, this early in the season?
I thought the same thing. I saw it was on my deck.
Yes.
It was a yellowy orange, a light colored, and I thought, I've never seen a worm this early. But, you know, it's interesting. There's no meteorological credence to it. I never pretended that it was. But it's just entertaining, and it's fun, and people love it every year. And 80% of the time, generally speaking, those little meteorology people, little critters, are actually pretty correct.
They had it the last 2 years, right?
They did.
I remember it was 3 years ago. They were a little off.
Yeah. If you're, you know,
20%.
That's not
bad. In your
world,
that's really good.
I would have liked that when I was doing the actual thing.
Right. Absolutely.
Okay, but here we're looking at other ways that people kind of make some predictions. So those are persimmons, yes?
Those are persimmon seeds, and they're interesting too. We used to do that in the studio. We'd take an X-Acto knife. If you ever do this at home, be careful. You can cut your finger off. But you cut open the seed of the persimmon, and there's either forks, knives, or spoons.
Is this a picture from this year?
This is this year.
Okay.
And I had several that were sent to me. I don't get as many pictures and reports, because I don't think people have persimmon seeds, perhaps. I mean, for trees. But a spoon represents a shovel.
So lots of snow.
Fork is mild, and a knife is biting icy cold. So all of the persimmon seeds this year were spoons.
Tell me about the
kids
squirrels. Seems like I've seen a lot A lot of squirrels this year.
If they're and acorns and so forth, I can't walk on my driveway anymore because of the acorns. There's so many of them. Mm-hmm. And so the squirrels have been busy, and that's kind of an indication of cold weather.
Mm. So, right. Well, we're going to see if the squirrels and the woolly worms and the persimmons all agree. We've got your reports scrolling at the bottom of the screen. We've seen a few pictures. We've got more. Judy is spending the hour with us, and coming up, we'll share a few more of your pictures.